Hello children, in this video we will learn to divide the whole into equal parts and express it as a fraction. Appu asked Bunny to pluck some mangoes from the garden and bring it to his house. In return, Appu would give him such a big rectangle shaped chocolate. On hearing this, Bunny agreed. When Bunny reached Appu's garden, he saw that the tree was very tall. Just then, Babban was passing by. He asked Babban for help. Babban told Bunny that he could pluck the mango by climbing up the tree. But in return, he would have to give him half of the chocolate. Children, do you know what half is? Suppose Bunny's chocolate is of such a rectangle shape. Now, if we divide it into two equal parts, like this, this part is one part of these two equal parts. We can also write it as a fraction in this way. Here, 2 is the total number of parts and 1 is one part of those two equal parts. We also call this half of this whole chocolate. Bunny agreed. Now Babban quickly climbed up the tree and plucked all the mangoes.
But what is this? How will both of them take these mangoes to Appu's house?
Neither of them has any basket or bag.
Look,
Chanda is passing by. She also has an empty basket. Babban and Bunny asked for her basket and told her the entire story. Chanda told them that she could give them her basket, but she wanted an equal share of the chocolate. So now they have to divide the chocolate into 3 equal parts. Children, can you tell how they can divide this chocolate into 3 equal parts? If you wish to, you may stop the video and find the answer. Well done, children. You have divided this correctly. Now, can you tell how can we express the parts got by each one of the 3 as a fraction? There are a total of 3 equal parts of the chocolate, and each one will get one part of it. Now, we can write it as a fraction in this way. We also call this 1/3 of the whole chocolate. In this way, all 3 will get 1/3 of the chocolate. Chanda also agreed and filled all the mangoes in the basket. But when they tried to lift the basket, it was too heavy and none of them were able to lift it. Just then, Bhola the donkey was passing by. Once again, Bhola also decided to help, and in return, he too asked for an equal share of chocolate for himself. Now, can you divide this chocolate into 4 equal parts? Write the part of the chocolate received by each one of them as a fraction. If you wish to, you may stop the video and find the answer. Well done, children! You have found the correct answer. We also call 1/4 as 1/4. Finally, the 4 of them reached Appu's house with the mango basket. Appu gave Bunny such a chocolate. He divided the chocolates into 4 equal parts, as found in the answer by you, and gave each of them one part of it. Children, in this lesson, we learned about dividing the whole into equal parts and how to write it as a fraction. Hello, children.
In the previous video, we learned about dividing the whole into equal parts and how to write it in the form of a fraction. In this video, we will see some interesting examples related to this. One day, Chanda was walking in the garden. There, she found a letter. It was written in the letter that she would have to find some clues. And if she solves all the clues, she would find a treasure. Chanda got excited. She quickly read the letter further. It was written in it that first Chanda will have to find a window whose 3/4 glass is blue. Children, can you write 3/4 as a fraction? Yes, we can write 3/4 as a fraction in this way. Children, do you remember that here the number 4 shows that our whole is divided into 4 equal parts, and 3 parts out of them are blue. Now Chanda started looking for that window. She finally saw such a window. Are 3/4 of the glass in this window blue? You can stop the video to find the answer. Yes, your answer is absolutely correct. This window is divided into 4 equal parts, out of which 3 parts are covered with blue colored glass. In this way, 3/4 of the window has blue glass. Chanda found her next clue under this window. It was written in that clue that she would have to find a roof whose 2/3 part is made of yellow bricks. Children, can you tell what kind of roof will it be? Yes, it will be a roof which is divided into 3 equal parts, and 2 parts of it would be made of yellow bricks. Chanda started wondering where she had seen such a roof before. Then she remembered that she had seen such a roof over her friend Golu Panda's house. Chanda immediately reached Golu's house. If the roof of Golu house is of this shape, then can you divide it into 3 equal parts and fill yellow color in 2/3 of it? If you wish to, you can find the answer by pausing the video. Well done, children! In this way, we can fill yellow color in 2/3 of the roof. Now, Chanda found her last clue near Golu's house. It was written in that clue that she has to find a circle whose 5 parts out of 6 equal parts are pink in color. Chanda does not know what this circle will look like. Can you help Chanda by making such a circle? You can find the answer by stopping the video. Well done, children! You have made it perfectly. There are 6 equal parts here, and 5 of them are pink. We can write it as a fraction in this way. Chanda remembered from the picture you made that she saw such a circle-shaped clock in Uncle's house. She immediately reached Barbole Uncle's house, and there she saw that Barbole Uncle had brought her most cherished nut. Actually, he had hidden all these clues to give Chanda a surprise. Children, in this lesson we have seen some interesting examples of how to divide the whole into equal parts and how to write it in fractions. Hello children, in the previous video we saw some interesting examples of how to divide the whole into equal parts and how to write it in fractions. In this video, we will learn about some misconceptions related to it. One day, Babban and the fox got lost in the forest. They had wandered a lot, but they could not find anything to eat. Both of them got tired and sat in the shade of a tree. Just then, they found a chapati there. Both of them became very happy. Now, both of them decided to divide the chapati in two halves. The fox divided the chapati in two parts like this and gave one part to Babban. Can you tell if the fox really gave Babban half of the chapati? Exactly! The fox did not give half part to Babban. The fox did not divide the chapati into two equal parts. So, the portion that Babban got was not half of the chapati. Children, if any object or shape is divided into unequal parts, then we cannot write it as a fraction. Fractions are made only from equal parts. The fox cleverly ate the larger piece of chapati. Now, while searching for the way out, they found such a rectangle-shaped cake. The cake was quite small. Babban understood that the fox had divided the chapati in unequal parts. So this time, he told the fox that she would have to make equal parts of the cake. The fox agreed. The fox split the cake into three equal parts in this way. The fox told Babban that she would eat two-thirds of the cake and Babban will eat one-third portion of the cake. When Babban could not understand, the fox wrote it in the form of a fraction. Children, the fox has divided the cake into three equal parts. But are they both getting equal amount of cake? The fox was once again fooling Babban. The fox has divided the cake into three equal parts. But Babban has got only one part, while the fox has got two parts. Hence, the fox has got more cake than Babban. The fox immediately ate two-thirds of the cake. Babban understood that the fox had once again made a fool of him. Now, while walking, they reached a marsh. Babban jumped up quickly and reached the other side of the marsh by hanging from one vine to the other. When the fox called out to him for help, Babban told her that when she finds the answer to how much is 2 by 0, then he will come to help her. Saying this, Babban left from there. Children, can we divide anything into zero parts? No. If there is an object, it will have at least one part. Because the whole of an object is equal to one part. Like, if we have this cake, we can write it as 1 upon 1, meaning this whole cake is one part and we are taking that whole portion. And zero parts means there is no part. And when there is no part, then how can we take two parts from it? The fox finally had to pay for her cunningness. Children, in this video, we learned about some misconceptions related to dividing the whole into equal parts and how to write it in fractions.
children.
In this video, we will learn about equivalent fractions. Raju and Bablu are going to buy watermelon from the market. They bought a watermelon from Bunny's stall and took it to Raju's house. Now, Raju told Bablu that he should divide the watermelon in two halves. Bablu cut the watermelon in two equal parts and gave one part to Raju. There are two equal parts of watermelon here, and both Raju and Bablu have taken a part of it. So we can say that both Raju and Bablu got 1/2 or half of the watermelon. Raju told Bablu that this portion is too big and he cannot eat it. So Raju cut those two big pieces into two equal parts. In this way, now the watermelon has four equal parts. Bablu gave two parts of them to Raju. Earlier, Raju and Bablu were getting one part out of two equal parts. And now, there are four parts of the watermelon. And they both are getting two parts. Children, is the amount of watermelon that Raju and Bablu are now getting more or less than before? If you wish to, you can stop the video and think about the answer. Absolutely right. Both are getting as much watermelon as before. Earlier, Raju and Bablu were getting one part out of two. That is 1/2 parts. And now, they are getting two parts out of four. That is 2/4 parts. Here, this one part is equal to these two small parts. And because the amount of watermelon they are getting is still the same, we can write that the fraction 1/2 is equal to the fraction 2/4. Such fractions that are equal are called equivalent fractions. Now Raju told Bablu that even now those pieces are quite big. Can he cut them into smaller pieces? Now he cut all the pieces from the middle and divided them into two pieces. Now, the whole watermelon is divided into 8 parts. And children, you can see, right? All these 8 parts are exactly the same. Now, if they have to take as much watermelon as before, that is, half watermelon, how many parts will Raju and Bablu get? Yes! Now, both will get 4 parts. That is, 4 parts out of 8. We can write the fraction of the watermelon given to Raju or Bablu in this way, as 4/8. Because both are getting 4 parts out of the total 8 parts. If you look closely, you will find that they are still getting half of the watermelon. So, we can write the fraction 1/2 is equal to the fraction 2/4 is equal to the fraction 4/8. All of these are equivalent fractions. Raju is now happy to see these pieces and together they start eating the watermelon happily. Children, in this video we learned about equivalent fractions. Hello children! In the previous video, we learned about equivalent fractions. In this video, we will see some interesting examples of this.
Today, Babban, Golu and Chanda have come to buy clothes from Barbole uncle's shop. Babban bought an 18-meter cloth of this design. Golu bought an 18-meter cloth of this design. And Chanda bought an 18-meter cloth of this design. When Babban reached his house, he thought, why not give 1/3 of his cloth to Golu and take a piece of the same length of cloth from him? In this way, they will have 2 different designs of cloth. Children, can you tell how Babban can make 1/3 of his cloth and how long will it be? If you wish to, you can stop the video and find the answer. Absolutely right! In this way, Babban will cut his cloth into 3 equal parts and take 1 part from it. And that would be 1/3 of the cloth. If we divide 18 meters into 3 equal parts, each part will be 6 meters long. If you wish to, you may see. This first part is 6 meters. The second part is also 6 meters. And this third part is also 6 meters. 6 meters plus 6 meters plus 6 meters equal to 18 meters. In this way, this 1/3 part of Babban's cloth will be 6 meters long. Babban took 1/3 of his cloth and reached Golu's house. He told Golu his idea and Golu agreed. But there was one problem. Golu had already cut his cloth into 6 equal parts. Can you tell how Golu will be able to give Babban a cloth as long as his cloth? Let's see. Golu placed parts of his cloth like this and placed Babban's cloth's part just above it. Now he sees that 2 parts of his cloth are equal to 1 part of Babban's cloth. Do you think the same? This means 1/3 part of Babban's cloth and 2/6 part of Golu's cloth are equal. Let's look at it in another way. We saw in the beginning of the video that 1/3 part of Babban's cloth is 6 meters long. The length of Golu's cloth is also 18 meters. And he has made 6 equal parts of his cloth. So, how many meters will the length of one part be? Or how many meters will be 1/6 of 18 meters? 3 meters. But Golu has given 2/6 part to Babban. That is 2 parts out of 6. In this way, Golu has given Babban 2 times 3 or 6 meters long cloth. So you see, children, Golu has given Babban equal length of cloth. Here the lengths of Babban and Golu's cloths are the same. And 1/3 of Babban's cloth is equal to 2/6 of Golu's cloth. Therefore, these fractions are equivalent fractions. Babban took Golu's cloth and went to his house. While going home, he thought, why not replace 1/3 of his cloth with equal piece of Chanda's cloth? In this way, he will have 3 designs of cloths. On thinking this, he immediately took one third of his cloth and reached Chanda's house. He told Chanda his idea too, and Chanda also immediately agreed. But Chanda had cut her cloth into 9 equal parts. Now, how will Chanda be able to give Babban a cloth as long as the part of his cloth? Chanda, just like Golu, placed parts of her cloth like this and placed Babban's cloth's part just above it. Now, she sees that 3 parts of her cloth are equal to 1 part of Babban's cloth. Children, is Babban's thinking correct? Are 1/3 part of Babban's cloth and 3/9 part of Chanda's cloth equal? Let us now look at it in another way. We know that 1/3 of Babban's cloth is 6 meters. The length of Chanda's cloth is also 18 meters and she has made 9 equal parts of her cloth. So, how many meters will the length of one part be? Or how many meters will 1/9 part of 18 meters be? 2 meters. But Chanda has given Babban 3/9 part, or 3 parts out of 9. In this way, Chanda has given Babban 3 times 2, or 6 meters long cloth. Therefore, 3/9 of Chanda's cloth is equal to 1/3 of Babban's cloth. And these two are also equivalent fractions. In this way, 1/3 is equal to 2/6 is equal to 3/9. All these are equivalent fractions. Babban took 3/9 part of Chanda's cloth from her and happily returned home. Hello children! In the last video, we saw some interesting examples of equivalent fractions. In this video, we will learn more about it through some more interesting examples. Today, Raju and Bablu are playing a unique game. Raju will write a fraction. Then, he will write the number below the equivalent of that fraction. And Bablu will have to find the number above it. Raju first wrote this fraction. Bablu started finding the fraction. Children, can you help Bablu? Raju wrote this fraction. Here, the number 2 shows how many parts of a thing are created. And the number 1 shows that we took 1 of those 2 parts. Like, if we divide this circle into 2 equal parts and fill color in 1 part, then we can write the colored part of the circle in the form of a fraction in this way as 1/2. Now, in this fraction, the number 8 shows how many parts of something are made. In this way, we can make a similar circle and divide it into 8 equal parts. Now, we have to find out how many parts of these 8 parts should we take so that it is equal to half of the first circle. If we put these on top of each other, then we can see that 8 parts of this circle are equal to 2 parts of the first circle. And 4 parts of this circle is equal to one colored part of the first circle. Therefore, we will color in four parts of this circle. In this way, we have the numeral above our equivalent fraction as 4. In this way, half is equal to 4/8. This is Raju's next fraction. Children, can you find this fraction? Let's find it using a different shape. We can show this fraction by dividing such a strip into 5 equal parts and coloring 3 parts in it. Now, how many parts are there in its equivalent fraction? 15. Come, let us make a strip of equal length of this strip just below it and divide it into 15 equal parts. Now, if we put this strip on top of the first strip in this way, we will find that 15 parts of this strip are equal to 5 parts of the first strip. Can you now tell how many parts out of 15 are equal to 3 colored parts of the bottom strip? Let's see. Yes, 9 parts. In this way, 3 by 5 is equal to 9 by 15. This is Raju's last fraction. Children, can you find this last fraction? If you wish to, you may find it by stopping the video. Well done, children! You have found it absolutely right. If we take 2 equal length strips and divide one of them into 3 equal parts and the other into 12 equal parts, and then put the second strip on top of the first strip, we will find that 3 parts of the first strip are equal to 12 parts of the second strip. And if we look closely, 8 parts of the second strip is equal to 2 colored parts of the first strip. Thus, 2 by 3 is equal to 8 by 12. With your help, Bablu found all of Raju's fractions. See how he is happily dancing. Children, in this video we learned more about equivalent fractions through some more interesting examples.